Closed captioning for the Casey Malone Show is sponsored by Hunter Stevens Land Title Agency. Integrity, service, and commitment you can trust.
Oh, yeah. Casey Malone is serving up local. It's time for the stories of our region, the tastes, the sights, the sounds, and the people in and around the valley. Get ready for some local flavor on the Casey Malone Show.
Today we enjoy a summer night with the music of the Youngstown Area Community Concert Band. And I prepare the classic dessert, Cherry's Jubilee. But first, low country cooking at Savannah Joe's. Well, you might have noticed a lot more activity at the corner of Glenwood and Canfield Road, and that is due to Savannah Joe's right here in the Glenwood Plaza. And Joe Bowers is Savannah Joe, and you have been greeted very warmly, haven't you, bringing this great food to our area?
Yes, I have.
And this is the food of your childhood?
Yes, this is the food that I grew up on.
Now, in Savannah, oh my God, I mean, that is such a city. And your family's all down there still?
Your parents, sisters still live in Savannah.
And how did you wind up in the, garden capital of the world, Youngstown, Ohio? What brought you here?
Well, when I was a kid, went through some things, and my parents, they put me on a bus and sent me up here to an aunt and uncle.
Okay.
And I got up here and it was the best move of my life. It changed my life.
They set
moving
you straight?
They set me straight.
See, you know, Youngstown does have therapeutic, healing, you know, vibes, I guess.
Yes.
And cooking has always been in your blood. I mean, have you always been in the food business?
Well, I started out as working in a restaurant. I started out in fast food at the age of 16. And worked from 16 to now I'm 52. All of my life I've been in the restaurant business.
I mean, you've never really got to cook the food from your youth, huh? You, when in other restaurants, you were doing just, you know, regular Americana fare.
Exactly. Whatever the menu was of those restaurants, I cooked that food. And then when I got a little older, I started catering and started cooking for my family and friends. And, and that's how I got into cooking soul food, the food that I grew up on.
And it had to be, I mean, you have the gumbo, shrimp and grits. You know, what other recipes did you bring up, you know, from when you were growing up?
Well, we have a crab cake. Back home, we call it deviled crab.
Yes.
That's real popular. We have a crab and shrimp casserole, which I'm going to run on a special. It's crab, lump crab meat jumbo shrimp with a crumb topping that we make. So those are all items that my mom cooked every week. And I grew up eating.
So you are, I mean, that's seafood heavy. I mean, you really do have a lot of seafood dishes, but I've got to tell you, your fried chicken is crazy good. I mean, it is light, but it's still so crispy, and that's your own recipe?
Yeah, we marinate that chicken for a minimum of 8 hours. So the chicken that we're gonna cook tomorrow will be marinated tonight, and it'll sit at 8 hours and marinate. And then we lightly bread it and we fry it fresh.
Oh, it is, it's so good. I mean, it really is. I mean, everything that I've had here, you know, the mac and cheese, everything is really good in your desserts. You make all of the red velvet, the banana pudding, everything?
Yes, I come in at 4 a.m. every morning.
Time to do the donuts.
Yeah, exactly. And I bake cakes and make banana pudding every day, fresh.
So how did this location and this restaurant come to be? You know, how did you wind up here?
Well, one day I was riding down the street and I saw the remodel of this plaza. They was painting the building. And so I called and inquired to the Youngstown Neighborhood Development. I said, I see you're doing a remodel on the plaza. I'm interested in opening a restaurant.
And they had to be thrilled.
And that's how it happened. So I filled out the application and went through the process and got selected for the lease here.
They have done so much. I mean, they are really, that is a great organization. And they are, I mean, this whole corridor, really, they really brought it back to life. Because there used to be so much activity here.
Right.
And have you been just greeted warmly? I mean, have you really been going crazy?
It's been phenomenal. The response and the greeting that we've gotten since we've been here. hundreds of people have come to try the food. And so it's great. The response has been great.
And what are your more popular dishes?
We sell a lot of catfish.
Yeah.
I think the fried catfish is my top seller. We sell a lot of pork chops. You know, when I put pork chops on the menu, I didn't realize how big of a seller pork chops would be.
Yeah.
But pork chops is one of the biggest sellers here.
Really? Now, what is the difference between your fried and then your smothered? What do you smother it with?
Gravy. So so the smothered pork chop, which I'm just adding back to the menu, we fry it and then we put it in a rich gravy with onions and seasonings, and it just marinates in the gravy for several hours.
You know, you said that you started out as, you know, table service.
Yes.
And you
had I started out table service, couldn't hire enough waitresses. So I ended up having to do carry out only. Not carry out only, they can still order and sit down in the dining room.
And sit in, yeah, but I think that is, a lot more restaurants are doing that, and I think it is because of the lack of servers.
Right.
And I mean, I thought it was still pretty efficient when, you know, she said, could be 15 minutes, like 5 minutes later, her food's coming out. For someone who's never had, you know, the low country, this type of food, what would you recommend to a beginner if they're coming here for the first time?
If they like seafood, the shrimp and grits is a big hit. If you like pasta, we have a Cajun salmon and shrimp Alfredo pasta, which is...
Your girls were really talking that up when I was
That's a real big hit from the seafood. The fried chicken, like you said,
yeah,
it's very good. The way we cook the chicken, it's juicy, it's hot, you know, it's flavorful.
It is, it's delicious.
So the chicken is good. And then the sides are good. You know, we make all of the sides fresh.
Well, obviously you are a man who loves what you do, because you know, you just whipped that right up and you knew exactly what you were looking for. This is amazing. We got to try this. This is one of my favorite dishes.
Shrimp and grits.
Oh man, this is what it is all about. The cheese, it's unbelievable. Any twist that you added that your mom and grandma didn't add? What did you do to make it Savannah Joe's?
Well, those jewel tomatoes, we marinate them in cumin and spices, and that adds a little kick to the gravy.
Man, I'll tell you, come on, Joe, have a shrimp with me. Well, cheers. These are amazing. Oh. This is heavenly. And look at smothered chicken, smothered pork chops. I mean, everything here is just awesome.
It's good.
It is. It is. You gotta come. Savannah Joe's, man.
Kamara Jewelers is the place to buy an engagement ring, because we want a relationship with you that lasts a lifetime. Your commitment with her is the same commitment we have to you.
We want to sit down with you and teach you about diamonds, so you're educated on what you're buying. We have the largest selection we ever have, which is the largest in the area, and at the best value. And if it's not something in our case, we could always custom make it. We can make any dream come true.
Get real, get Kamara.
Join the Isle and Purple Cat family. Employment opportunities are available. Given is living.
Join the Isle and Purple Cat family. Employment opportunities are available at $13 an hour. Given is living.
Woolley Brothers has a great choice of quality cheeses. We use our relationship with Old World Houses to specially select the product and then have it custom cut and packaged by our own local artisans. At Woolley Brothers Market, our family is in the store.
I'm all about local, and my bank is Farmers National Bank. Farmers is the true hometown bank in the Mahoning Valley, standing strong for our local families and businesses since 1887. Farmers is also future-focused with a lab branch, interactive teller machines, and best-in-class mobile mortgage app. We've all learned the value of local relationships, businesses, and communities. Switch to Farmers. Today's cooking segment is all about the cherry.
Okay, I like the cherry.
We have a very limited season for stone fruit. So yes, you gotta get a lot of it and get it out of your system before you get sick of it. And these cherries are fabulous. I bought pounds of them and I've been doing all kinds of recipes. And I think this time we are just gonna do a really nice cocktail, the cherry smash. And then we are going to do that classic old dessert, Cherry's Jubilee.
Cherry's Jubilee, yeah.
And we've had a lot of fun, you know, making sure and tweaking all the things.
I just don't think this is quite right. Let's do it again.
Let's do that smash one more time.
That's all I need is more ice cream.
But I also bought myself a little gift, and it is so much fun. It's the cherry pitter. You take out the stem, you wash the thing, and then you go like this. Look.
That's easy.
And there's the little pit.
Yeah.
And there you have it. Is that awesome? So this is a fun little thing to do because nobody wants the pit in their cherry. And I am just in love with this thing. I love it. I love it. For this recipe, you'll need 3 cherries, washed and pitted, a slice of orange, a dash of bitters, 2 ounces of bourbon, 3/4 ounce of sweet vermouth, 1/2 ounce of simple syrup, the juice from 1/2 lemon, and a sprig of mint for garnish. All right, this is the cherry smash. Now, because there's 2 of us, we're gonna double the recipe. Online, though, it'll be for just a singular one.
All right, so you're gonna direct me, right?
So yeah, we're gonna start with 3 fresh cherries at the bottom of each glass. I call them highball glasses.
Right, so 1, 2, 3.
Right, and now you will muddle the cherries.
A little bit of bitters to muddle with.
That's not, you can do it either way. It's in the glass either way.
Okay.
So muddle it with the bitters.
Okay, there's the muddler.
Love the little muddler.
All right.
Sounds like a character in Batman. The muddler. All right, now it is the sexy shaker time. Okay, after you've muddled.
Okay, good.
All right.
I've got ice.
You've got ice. Yeah. So let's start with, it'll be 4 ounces of bourbon since it's both of us drinking. That's right. Always measure.
I don't always measure. But since I've met you.
Well, you have to because it can get out of hand.
People need to know.
Right. And then we are going to use the sweet vermouth and it'll be 1.5 ounces because we're doubling it. I know.
There you go.
And then we are going to need the 1 ounce of simple syrup.
That's this one.
Yes.
Okay.
And then it'll be the juice of 2 lemons.
Juice of 2 lemons.
Yes.
I already did that.
Now, what about the orange?
Throw an orange slice here for a little extra muddling.
Okay.
How's that?
That sounds good.
All right.
And then we're gonna shake it up.
And that's it.
That's it. Fort Pitt, that is it. Oh, and then we have the, what do you call that? The mint. And we are going
to stir with a mint thing?
That's kind of like your swizzle stick.
So you don't wanna shake too much, right?
Because you don't wanna bruise the bourbon.
Who taught you that?
Now we are using
a
rye.
So I'm just gonna let it sit for a minute. All right,
okay.
Quick little sit, there you go.
And you do not serve this on the rocks, it's neat. I guess it would be called neat, even though it's chilled, right?
Yeah.
And it's just a little sipper. But boy, I'm telling you, it's a good sipper.
Okay, so then I'm gonna take some mint and do a little of this. How's that? Anything for a little extra flavor. There you go.
All right.
1, 2, 3.
And then we'll just leave
that for you, young lady.
All righty. Cherry smash.
Smells the same. There you go.
Cheers.
Cheers. Wow.
I think this is the better than the ones we were doing last night.
The problem is you just don't sip it. You know, you do have to really make an effort at sipping it.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot, you know, it's just kind of straight, so.
It tastes so good.
Like an old fashioned or a Manhattan. This is how, yeah, it's a sipper. It's a sipper. So, we got to get some food in us. So next,
yeah,
it is Cherries Jubilee. For this recipe, you'll need 1 pound of fresh, ripe, sweet cherries, cleaned and pitted, 1/3 cup granulated sugar, the juice of 1/2 lemon, 1/3 cup of rum, and vanilla ice cream for serving. Well, one of my favorite desserts is Bananas Foster. Love it. And it's so sexy, you know, yeah. They serve it tableside. And the same with Cherries Jubilee. And they're so easy to make. All you need is the right ingredients. And within 5 minutes, you have got a serious classic dessert.
It involves ice cream.
And it involves ice cream. Both of them do. So you're going to love this.
I'm in.
All right. So first thing we're going to do is get a fairly large skillet and a pound of cherries that are washed and pitted. Of course, you knew that. And then, yeah, put it on a medium low. Now, a pound of cherries, what I did was I figured about a dozen cherries per serving. And this is enough for 4. So, Gina, I hope you're hungry for some Cherries Jubilee. Now we are going to add the lemon juice and the sugar. Okay, so stir that all together. And then what we're gonna do is cover it, and then it will get syrupy. We'll put the cover over for about 5 minutes, 5 to 10 minutes, and let all those juices, and the sugar and the lemon will draw it out of the cherries, and it'll get nice and gooey.
You're good?
Yeah, 5 minutes.
5 minutes.
Wow, look at all the juices that are extracted. So now we add dark rum. I'm using Black Seal from Bermuda. The traditional recipe calls for Kirsch, which I couldn't locate. It's got some, it's a brandy that's cherry based. But this worked perfectly. Get
looks
that
beautiful.
Nice and cooked. And I've already got the vanilla ice cream waiting. Mmm. It really is a treat.
That's unbelievable.
What a treat. You saw how easy it is. Mm. But remember.
It's delicious.
You don't have to use alcohol in this.
Right.
There's just enough juice. You just want to make sure, maybe add a little more lemon juice to extract more so you just have, because you really want to use
the cherry juice.
Mmm. It is delicious. One more time, look at me, I'm like a pig. Cherries Jubilee. Cherry smash. Go to thecaseymaloneshow.com under recipes.
You can't stop eating them.
And you are going to find the recipes. Easy, take advantage. It's a short time that we can enjoy cherries. And a toast meat, mm-hmm. Could you quit? I know it's good.
Cheers.
Cheers.
I'm Elizabeth Bernard. For more than 30 years, I've provided our Valley with sound legal advice. My associate, Jennifer Rigetti, and I will be your legal representatives if you're involved in a car, truck, or motorcycle accident. Don't try to handle it yourself. We'll navigate the red tape of dealing with doctors, medical insurance, and all the obstacles that you'll face. Remember, there are no upfront fees on personal injury cases, and hiring a lawyer does not mean you have to go to court.
Call attorney Elizabeth Bernard, local legal experience for more than 30 years.
It's happening now. Construction is underway at Gabba Camp.
A year-round destination for adults with disabilities and their families to get away close to home, accessible to all, with no barriers.
Donate now to Gabba Camp. Giving is living.
Ruli Brothers is way ahead of the competition. Check out Ruli Spice World, where you can buy bulk herbs and spices, plus candies, nuts, and fillings for pennies on the dollar. At Ruli Brothers Market, our family is in the store.
We'll be right back.
Well, we really lucked out tonight. We have a gorgeous, beautiful summer evening, and we're here at Boardman Park to see the Youngstown Area Community Concert Band. This is the conductor, Joe Pellegrini, and you guys are going to be around. It's going to be 40 years now.
Next year will be our 40th year, yeah.
And have you been involved that long?
Not quite. The band started in 1983.
Yeah.
And there were two directors between that year and 1990. In 1990,
I took over. And I mean, this is really an interesting group of musicians. Nobody's getting paid. This is all volunteer.
Total volunteers. Most of them are people that just played in high school.
Mm-hmm.
There are a few people we call, quote, professionals, because they're music teachers.
Well, you were a music teacher,
yes,
weren't you?
Yeah, in Austin Town for 34 years, yeah.
And have any of your students joined?
Yes, over the years,
so cool.
I've had a few of the students. And it's so nice that, you know, after they've graduated, they're adults.
Yeah.
And it's a whole different relationship. It's kind of neat. But yeah, right now we've got some college kids that are like in their early 20s.
Yeah.
All the way up. I'm not sure if we have any 80-year-olds, but we got some close. So everything in between.
How many are in the band?
It fluctuates, of course, because some people, you know, they're in and out and they can play and then they can't. In the neighborhood of 50 to 55.
That's a lot.
So, yeah.
And how do you recruit? You know, where do you find the people?
It's mostly word of mouth. At concerts, I'll mention something about if you're interested, go on the website, and if you're interested in playing, contact us.
What do you need right now? Are you lacking any instruments? Like, is there anything you're on the prowl for?
Yeah, we could use instruments like bassoons, low woodwinds, bass clarinets, those instruments.
I have a tuba player down the street.
You need a tuba? We do not turn any. We could have 20 clarinets and somebody wants to play, you're the 21st.
How many concerts do you do in the summertime? Because you guys are pretty active.
Yes. Before COVID, COVID kind of knocked us down quite a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Before that, in the neighborhood of 8 to 12, couple years, we had maybe 14 during the summer, from May till usually the beginning of August.
That's a lot.
Occasionally, we've had a September concert or an October concert, and occasionally we've had an April concert, but most of them are late May through the beginning of August.
And a lot of them are the outdoor
parks, here and Austin Town Park. And
do you have time for a lot of rehearsals?
We rehearse every Thursday evening. So obviously tonight,
yes,
it's a performance, which is fine. We start, our year actually begins in September. So we start in September, get ready for our Christmas music.
Yes, and I mean, that is an annual event.
Yes.
At Stamp Auditorium.
Right.
And how much have you raised so far for Second Harvest?
It's in the mid 40,000s. It's wonderful.
I mean, that is a great tradition that you have. It really is.
I can't take all the credit because it's with the Stambach Chorus. They're a chorus like we are a band. They're a volunteer chorus. Dr. Heizhong Lee, who teaches at YSU, he's their conductor. And so we do that in December. And then we take about a month off. We come back the end of January, start getting ready for our summer music, January.
That's wonderful. Now. And then where do you get your funding, you know, to help people? You know, you have your shirts and website and things like that.
We, the band as a group, not individually, of course, but the band as a group gets an amount from a venue.
Oh, okay.
Here in Austintown, we get a check and it goes into our fund. We have received grants
and donations
from the city, donations, and I think, I hope I'm not leaving someone out, Monday Musical, and those people have
that's really nice.
Foundation. We do a thing around Christmas, around Thanksgiving. We sell handles, ice cream cards.
Yes.
And they go like crazy. I mean,
who doesn't want
handles
ice cream?
Best ice cream in the country.
Exactly.
Right here.
Right here in the valley. So what kind of selections will you be playing in your summer concerts?
This year we're doing, our theme is actually titled Ohio Music and Musicians Composers. Everything that we're gonna play tonight was written by someone born in Ohio. We're doing marches by Henry Fillmore,
okay.
Carl King. Claire Grundman is a gentleman that did great arrangements. He was born in Cleveland.
Okay.
A name that's familiar to everybody, Henry Mancini.
Now, I thought he was Pennsylvania, but he's Ohio.
His family moved when he was a very young child. They moved to, and I better do this for my hairdresser, he moved to West Aliquippa.
That's okay. And so, but he was born here.
He was born in Little Italy section of Cleveland.
Where can we, just go to your website and it'll have your full list of performances?
It has everything. It has information if you want to join the band, if anything. It's very easy to remember, yaccb.org, because this is the Youngstown Area Community Concert Band, so there's our...
And you're a nonprofit, so
yes.
You get the org.
Yes, and that's why all of our concerts are free, even like the Stambach concert.
Yes.
It's a donation of any amount, and every penny, not one penny is taken away for our expenses. Every penny goes to the Second Harvest.
The Casey Malone Show is sponsored in part by Denise and John York and the DeBartlow Corporation.